talk about some stuff. So we've now seen some convergent and divergent series. I mean, in general, seeing the geometric series, which can converge or diverge. We've seen the P-series, which can converge or diverge. And we've seen a few kind of special cases, like Grandi's series, which is neither of those, but diverges. So let's start by making a few general statements about convergent and divergent. Statement one. The convergence or divergence of the sum from M to infinity of A sub N does not depend on M. And this is a pretty convoluted way of making a pretty elementary observation that we're adding an infinite number of terms together. And if like we want to get rid of the first five terms, that's not going to change whether the sum is finite or infinite. So I mean, all I'm saying here is like, we know that the sum from one to infinity of 1/n diverges. We saw that using the integral test yesterday. What about the sum from 5 to infinity of 1/n? Does it converge or diverge? Well, it still diverges. Stopping off the first, second, third, and fourth term don't affect the convergence or divergence of the series. And this fact can occasionally be helpful. Like the integral test requires that all of the terms be positive. So you can imagine a situation where you have just a few negative terms near the beginning of the series, and then everything else is positive. And according to what we have here, well, you can just cut those negative terms right out. You can just start where everything is positive. So like if we had a modified version of the harmonic series, -1/5 -1/4 -1/3 -1/2. Thus, we'll have to skip -1. We don't have to skip that. We can't divide by 0, so we'll have to skip but if you had this series, I mean, you can't really use the integral test on it, at least theoretically, according to what we said yesterday. because the integral test requires that everything be positive. But according to what we have on this frame, okay, you can get rid of the first few terms. We can just scribble all of this out and then look at what remains. 1 over n from 1 to infinity, and we can use the integral test and show that that diverges. So it's occasionally useful in that regard. Another occasionally useful statement is that let K be non-zero. So a constant other than zero, then the series A sub N and the series K A sub N either both converge or both diverge. So, you know, a simple example of this, what if you have 1/3 times 1/n. Well, 1/n by itself would diverge. It would be the harmonic series, but we're multiplying it by a constant. We're multiplying it by 1/3. So the question then is, well, could this constant be changing convergence? Could it be because that 1/3 is there, this series now converges? And the answer to that question, according to the last frame, is no. Having a constant in front of a divergent series will not cause that series to converge. So this still diverges. Similarly, maybe we have 5/2n. This we can rewrite as 5 times 1/2 to the n. And now, hopefully, we can make the leap that 1/2 to the n is the same as, well, I guess this isn't a great example. This is just a geometric series. It converges because 1/2 is less than 1 in absolute value. Always get these convergent, these geometric series and these P series mixed up. 5/n³. This is a better example because this is basically a P series. And P here I mean, if we just looked at 1 over n cubed, 3 is greater than 1. So if we just looked at the part of this expression that I circled, this would be a convergent series. Okay, but we're multiplying it by 5. So what's that do? And the answer is that it doesn't do anything. I mean, in terms of convergence, if a series converges, then 5 times that series converges. So those are some kind of generic remarks I wanted to make. They might actually in the textbook have shown up in one, maybe in 10.2, but they're fine here as well. Does anybody have questions before we go on to 10.4?